Good morning, dear friends. Myself, Dr. K.K. Padmana, Associate Professor, working in Maharani Science College, in the Department of Chemistry. So today, I am going to discuss about the heterocyclic compounds, which is a part of Mysore University 5th semester Organic Chemistry syllabus. In the heterocyclic compounds chapter, so we have to know about what is the definition of heterocyclic compounds, what is the importance of these compounds, and what are the different types of heterocyclic compounds, and how to preserve these compounds, and what are their properties. So these are the five points we have to discuss under this chapter, heterocyclic compounds. Now in your previous semester, you studied about cyclic compounds. Cycloalkanes and aromatic compounds you have studied. They are present in the form of ring. If you take one compound, if you read the structure like this. So this is a six-membered ring, and these atoms present in six corners, they are known as ring atoms. There are six ring atoms present in six membered ring. When all the ring atoms are same, then it is called homocyclic compounds. Generally, in organic compounds, all the ring atoms are carbon atoms. So, cycloalkanes and aromatic compounds are homocyclic. In some compounds, one or more ring atoms can be replaced by three elements known as nitrogen, sulfur, oxygen. These three elements can replace carbon atom of the ring. And the compounds which contain these elements as a part of the ring are called heterocyclic compounds. Hetero means different. So the cyclic compound containing hetero atom as a part of ring are called heterocyclic compounds. It may be nitrogen, or it may be sulfur, or it may be oxygen. So these are the three heterocyclic compounds. Now let us define what are heterocyclic compounds. So heterocyclic compounds are organic compounds present in cyclic structure containing one or more hetero atom as a part of such compounds are called heterocyclic compounds. And these three elements are known as heteroatoms. Now, which atom is present as a heteroatom? And the heterocyclic compounds are called as nitrogen heterocyclic compound, oxygen heterocyclic compound, and sulfur heterocyclic compound. That's how they are named. So, which indicates the hetero atom present in this cyclic structure. Nitrogen heterocyclic compound, oxygen heterocyclic compound, and sulfur heterocyclic compound. Now, what is the importance of these compounds in nature and in biological system? Nitrogen heterocyclic compounds, they are very, very vital compounds which are essential for all biological system. So nitrogen heterocyclic compounds, they are present in the nucleic acid, DNA and RNA, which contains nitrogen base, adenine, guanine, cytosine, ionic acid. These are the nitrogen bases present in nucleic acid. They are nothing but nitrogen heterocyclic compounds. And other type of compounds known as alkaloids, which we are going to discuss in later class, There also nitrogen heterocyclic compounds. And uric acid, which is present in urine, excreta, so it is nothing but nitrogen heterocyclic. And nitrogen heterocyclic compounds are very, very important in the biological system, which are responsible for hereditary characters. Second heterocyclic compound, oxygen heterocyclic compound. Oxygen heterocyclic compounds, they are also very important in biological system, and without oxygen heterocyclic compound, probably it cannot survive. Now, whatever the food we consume, they contain carbohydrates. When you get half of the structure of carbohydrates, then you get generally a planar structure with oxygen atom. So, oxygen atom is a heteroatom, it is a 6 member or 5. This is known as pyranose structure, and this is known as furanose structure. So, oxygen is a heteroatom, so they are oxygen heterocyclic compounds. So, carbohydrates, all carbohydrates are oxygen heterocyclic compounds. So, nitrogen heterocyclic compounds and oxygen heterocyclic compounds are very, very important for the life on the earth. Sulfur heterocyclic compounds are of not much important because they are present in nature in millions of them and the importance is also very limited. So, nitrogen heterocyclic compound and oxygen heterocyclic compounds are very important. So, that is the importance of heterocyclic compounds. Now, let us think how to classify these heterocyclic compounds. So, heterocyclic compounds are classified into three types. Heterocyclic compounds are classified into three types based on first one, 5 member heterocyclic compound. 5 member heterocyclic compounds, they are 5 member containing heteroatom. So, example, if you write a 5 member ring and oxygen has the heteroatom, so this compound is known as furan. And other one, if nitrogen is the heteroatom, then it is known as pyro. If sulfur is the heteroatom, then it is known as pyro. There are so many compounds, but only let us restrict to these three compounds which are mentioned in the syllabus: furan, pyro, thiophene. They are 5-member heterocyclic compounds. Second one, 6-member. 6-member heterocyclic compounds. 6-member heterocyclic compounds are 6-member ring containing heteroatom. So, example, 6-member ring with nitrogen as heteroatom. So, this compound is known as pyridine. And other one, 2 nitrogen atoms at pentaposition. So, this is the next thing. Pyridine, pyrimidine are 6-member heterocyclic compounds. Third type of heterocyclic compounds are fused ring heterocyclic compounds. Fused ring heterocyclic compounds. In this type, either 5-member or 6-member heterocyclic ring is fused to another aromatic ring. So, example, if you fuse pyrrole ring,
Fire ring is closed to benzene ring. It is known as indoor. So here, two rings are closed to benzene. Or, pyridine ring is closed to benzene ring. Then it is known as phenolin. Phenolin. Or, in the same way, pyridine ring is attached to the benzene, the position of attachment is different, then it is known as isomer. So these three compounds are mentioned in the syllabus, they are fused with heterocyclic compounds. So 5-membered heterocyclic compounds, 6-membered heterocyclic compounds, and fused with heterocyclic compounds. Now, how to number this heterocyclic compounds? For numbering, always you have to start either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Start from hydro atom. So here always you have to number as 1 for oxygen, either 2, 3, 4, 5 or 1, 2, 3, 4. In either way, we can number, but always you have to start from this oxygen. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 1, 2, 3, 9. So always you have to start from hydro atom and either in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Number. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Derivative is same. When two hetero atoms are present, you have to start from one hetero atom and move in the direction that second hetero atom also gets a minimum number. Now in this case, always start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we can't number in this direction. Because if you count in this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it comes 5. So you have to number in only clockwise direction here. 1, 2, 3, or 1, 2, 3, in any way. If you start from this side, then it comes 3. Or if you start from this side, then this comes 3. So these are you have to number when more than one nitrogen hetero atoms are present in the ring. So that the hetero atoms should get in number. In case of fusion, ring compounds. Here it is a bridge. This is a bridge acting between these two rings. So they should get always highest number. So numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because if you take this is the 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, again you can't go. So always we have to move further, you can't go back. So then this bridge atoms should always get the highest number. Therefore, the numbering always now in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In this case, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, this is a bridge atoms, so they should get the highest number. For that reason, always you have to number in this fashion. Whereas in case of isopropyl, so if you start from the hetero atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then we have to move to this one, then 9, 10. It's not possible. After 8, you can't go back. For this reason, so we start from this atom only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just to get highest number for the atoms. So even though the nitrogen is present here, we start from this atom and we move in this direction. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In this way, we have to number heterocyclic compounds. When only one atom is present, so we have to start from that atom and move either in clockwise or in anti-clockwise. In case of fusionic compounds, we have to number such that the bridge atom should get highest number. In this case, in isopropyl only, so we don't follow that rule, so we have to start from hetero atom. So, we start from this atom and in this case, second point. So, this is how we have to number heterocyclic compounds. So, heterocyclic compounds are classified into three types based on the ring structure. 5-membered heterocyclic compounds, 6-membered heterocyclic compounds and fused ring heterocyclic compounds. In the next session, let us discuss how to prepare these compounds and what are the properties of these compounds.
Thank you very much.